All right, what's going on, dudes? And welcome back to another episode of Hardcore Survival. Since we last left off, spent some more time strip mining because you may recall we came up empty-handed in the Way of Diamonds at the end of the last episode, and I was like, well, we probably want to get some so that we don't get wrecked by the Ender Dragon and the Wither and all that sort of stuff. So I made another strip mine. Just didn't want to get, like, too far away from the base over here. And also, I felt really unlucky with the strip mine, and I was like, all right, let's try a different direction. And lo and behold, 26 diamonds. Fortune 3 kind of helps a lot. I think that was like from 10 or 11 diamond ore. So pretty good stuff. So I came back, didn't want to waste all my torches. So I detorched the hallways as I returned home. But now we can make at least a diamond sword and a bit of diamond armor. Do we have enough? Let's see. What is it? I always forget the exact amount. I should probably memorize how many of whatever ore I need in order to make a full set of armor. What is it? 8 plus 7, 15, 20, 24. I didn't... Is it really 24? Did I really just end up with the exact amount required to make a full set of armor plus a sword? That's quite fortuitous. Okay. Nice. Nice. Alrighty then. People are gonna be like, you must have specifically engineered that. Nope. That's just highly coincidental, actually. Alright, well, fair enough. Let's do a set of diamond armor plus a sword. It is that, right? Yeah, 15, because 7, 8, 15. Yeah, it's definitely 24. Alrighty then, let's make it. Also, I dumped a lot of cobblestone on the way because I felt that we probably didn't need that much of it. So, alrighty. Anywho, sirs, what do we have here? Alright, iron can go back, I guess. I stopped really collecting any other resources. I was like, alright, if it's not diamond or if it's not directly in my path, I'm just gonna kind of ignore it. So, maybe not the best strategy in many people's books, but it is what I did. So, alright, we got the sword first. Do I want to make another diamond pickaxe is the question, though. I can't even stand the suspense. We gotta just go and see what it gives us if we put it in. Alright, sharpness 3, knockback 1, knockback 1. I like the sharpness 3. Sharpness 4 would be even better, but sharpness 3, you know, not bad at all. So I'm probably going to go for that. But let me check what time it is, because I'm thinking, since we're going to be pretty geared out, I'm hoping it's sunset? Sunrise. Nice. Nice. Because what I wanted to do was go out and kill some Endermen. So, well, hey, whatever. It is what it is. Can't really use that sword for it either, because they freak out. Alright, so anyway, well, I guess we're going to make some diamond armor, shall we? Let's do this thing. Alright, boom, and then a helmet, and then some booties. Alright, boom. There we go. We got our diamond armor, and is that what is actually more protecting? Is it straight diamond armor, or is it iron with protection? I don't actually know the answer to that question. That's a good one to think about. Because, right, an iron sword plus sharpness is better than straight diamond, I think. So, yeah. I wonder if the same applies for protection 1 plus... I feel like I don't need half the things that are in this thing here. Like, why do I even have half the stuff that I have? I don't know. I'm hoarding things. What can I say? Iron, I guess, can go up here. Yeah, I guess I just need to make some more chests. Why don't we go out and harvest some more wood? Seem to have a distinct lack of that, basically, at all times. So, yep. Yippity-yep. Hey, at least we got a diamond sword, and it's daytime. We can harvest some wood, and then by the time it's nighttime, hopefully we'll be able to do it. If I could get some experience, too, actually, that would be fantastic. That way I can at least enchant the diamond sword or enchant something, like chestplate. And then go back into the nether and get more levels and, I don't know, carrots. I love carrots. I'm going to go harvest some more, too. All right, carrots. Here I come. There have got to be a lot of you just, like, ripe and ready to be harvested. Pigs, you like some carrots? Yeah, I can tell you like some carrots. I can also tell that creepers like to kill me when I have carrots, so I'm going to be very, very careful here. Oh, hey, you wanna become part of the pig colony over here? You're totally welcome, except the problem is I don't want to open that fence, because that would be very, very dangerous. Okay, potatoes, and boom, and boom. All right. Cool. We're good there. And just want to replant. You guys, you're sort of getting in the way. As much as I know you love carrots, but I kind of need to replant them. Otherwise, You're not going to have forever carrots. It's going to be temporary carrots, and you want forever carrots. Like, diamonds are forever, carrots can be forever, as long as you keep replanting them. It's the magic of agriculture and biology and plants and seeds and germination and whatever other fancy terminology there is to describe the process of punching pigs while trying to harvest carrots. It's pretty cool. Alright, guys. Alright, and then I guess we even have some more carrots over here. These can last us a while, and then I feel like I have to replant them all, because we've got to be kind to the environment. Please be kind, rewind. It's like the exact, you know, it's the same principle here as be kind, rewind, right? It's be a jant, instead of a jant, replant. I was stretching that rhyme a little bit. Be a mensch. Replench. God dang it. I'm trying to come up with a really good slogan here for why you should replant. Be a branch. Replant. Be a plant. Replant. That rhyme. That was a good rhyme. It's great. Using the same word to rhyme with itself. Jordan, you're a genius. Be an ant. Replant. Do ants replant things? Don't say I can't. Replant! That's a good one. We're going with that. Woo! Finally got a slogan. Took long enough. Alright. Alright, pigs. Give me those enchantment levels. Pretty please, so I can just lag my entire world. Alright. There we go. Hey, exact. Whoa. Just used up that one thing and it was exactly 30 levels, like right then and there. Okie dokie, we've got 30 levels. What do we want to do? I'm going to go and see what our options are here as far as the chest plate versus the sword versus the stuff. What do we have? Protection 3. Nah, I'd prefer Protection 4 to be on it. Protection 3. Is it Protection 3 on... Oh, Aqua Affinity. That's not bad. And then Protection 3. Okay, so we're going to do the sword first. And we're going to be like, bam! Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am! What do we have?
Are you for real, though? Like, really? Like, really?
You're just gonna give me sharpness. Like, no other stuff. No sharpness 4, fire aspect 2, unbreaking 3. It's just sharpness 3. That's so anticlimactic. Like, this diamond sword's way better for wither or zombies and stuff. But, hey, at least we can kill Endermen easier with this, I suppose. God, that's lame. Fire protection 4, that's a good one. You still going to be fire protection 4? Yes, you are. I can deal with a fire protection, blast protection 4. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good, blast protection 4. Dang. I can be very fiery and blasty resistant-y. Something like that. I don't know. Anyway. Alrighty then. On the topic of things going back into a chest, I suppose we don't really need all these carrots, nor do we need all that lapis, nor do we need all that redstone, but we kind of do need to get rid of... Yeah, I just want to clear out my space a little bit. And also, that was what I was going to do, was I was going to go and collect some trees, and then I got totally, totally sidetracked by stuff, including my phone ringing. One moment. All right, let's go tree-capitate some tree doohickers. This forest just keeps receding further and further away. I have to go on more and more of a journey every time that I want to go and chop down some trees. Oh, man, maybe I should plant a forest near the house. I don't know. I do have a lot of saplings, but bone meal, I probably have a lot of bone meal too. I haven't checked that in a while, but hey, maybe it's worth doing, because, right? Don't say I can't. Be sure to replant. All right, I'm not much concerned about collecting all the things that drop, but yeah, alrighty then. All right, let us go and do this thing. I still have to decide if I want to make that golden apple. Don't have to decide quite yet, but I should probably decide, well, before I fight the Wither. Who knows how long down the road that's going to be. I'm going to have to go and, like, make and try to enchant 50 different iron swords to try to, oh boy, get something to go and, like, I wonder if it would be best to go and just get level 1 a bunch of times over and just try to get it so that it says looting 3 in the 30 level slot and then go from there. I don't know what the best strategy is to, I don't know, man. It's freaking dilemmas and stuff. So, hey, we got a lot of wood that we can now use in order to do stuff with. I love chests. Chests are pretty cool. I'm going to make two of them so that they can be together. Be a nice, happy couple of chests. I'll put them right there. And then they can be happy together. And then I can, like, put more stuff in there. And yeah. All right. Beautiful stuff. Beautiful, beautiful. Oh, I should try the bow as well. Because that could be good. Let's see. What do we have here? Unbreaking 3. When it starts with Unbreaking 3, I'm always like, it's not that great. Unbreaking 3. I want to... Give me something else. We still have the fire protection stuff over there, but that's fine. Let's see. What can we enchant the crafting table to? Nothing? How about the stick of... The hurdy stick? Nope. No hurdy sticks up in here. If only you could enchant your arrows, too. That would be great. But alas... You cannot. It's a sad, sad day. All right. Well, anyway. Oh, look at that. Three Eyes of Ender. It's time to go and slay out some mobs with our Sharpness 3 sword. Specifically Enderman. But hey, at least maybe we'll be able to get up to level 30 again. So we can kill two birds with one stone, right? Yeah, that's the plan. Right about meow. All right, mobs. Where are you at? Where are my mobs at? Hey. God, there you are. There you are. Okay, we need some Endermen up in here. Also, maybe if we let the pigs breed some more, we can get some more levels out of that. It's got a whole host of opportunities on our hands, but mostly we need Endermen. I wish that Eye of Enders weren't such a pain to get. You know, usually the frames come with at least a couple filled in, and I have to imagine that it's sort of related to the whole probably it being a bug that it spawns in the ocean. Don't get me wrong, it's a bug that I'm perfectly happy to take advantage of, but it's probably not at all filled in due to it being sort of a bug kind of thing. But hey, you know, gotta compromise there. Can't have it all. Even though I want it now. It's Enderman slaughtering time. Come on, Ender. There we go. We got two mighty fine specimens over there. Great. Dismount the horse. We can have it just in case we get into a bit of a pickle over here. Boom. And boom. Two angry Endermen. All following me. This is good. This is good. This is good. Get out of the way. Spidey, I can't kill the Endermen because of the grass. Okay, and you're both dead, and neither of you dropped a pearl. Wow, what great, awesome things you are. Hey, stop eating grass. We've got more important things to do. I should be... Hey, that's a good saying for a horse. Don't be an ass. You better not eat grass. Because that would be something that donkeys would do. Ha! That's funny. Because we have more important things to do than, hey, Enderman, how are you doing? So glad that you would go ahead and spawn for me. That's really kind of you. So glad that you could be here. It's pretty cool stuff. How about an Ender Pearl? That'd be really nice if you could get an Ender Pearl, but you wouldn't do that for me, cool, would you? Because you're just a terribly stingy individual. You're a stingy individual. God, I hate stingy individuals. Oh my god, that's a gaggle of witches over there. That's just too many. I can't tend to that many. That's just wait. There's six. Six. Which witch is which? I don't even know. All I know is I really need to find Enderman. You guys, you're not going to be like the others, right? I can sense it. I can smell it in you. I can smell it in you. Yeah. I could smell that pearl that you wanted to give me. You just, I don't blame you for trying to attack. You're not. No, don't do it. Oh, God, that was almost really bad. It was almost really bad. Hi-ho, silver away. Wrong way. Not that way. Okay, I'm going to eat some stuff. God dang it. I mean, I could go for the mob spawning thing, but that generally just doesn't work that well. Let's be honest here. Just not that good. Goodbye. Goodbye. I should have just gone and collected some experience from these dudes. Get Shrek'd by my horse. It looks like my horse is kind of eating you. All right, well, I don't know, man. I guess that's about that when it comes to our Enderman Knight. We've got two more. It brings our total to 5 as soon as I craft it. Not the greatest, but oh well. I guess it'll do. I'll do, donkey. That'll do. Remember, don't be an ass. Don't eat any grass. Okay? Yeah. It's my new slogan. We're taking it to again to like Target and Walmart and all the big names are all over it again. I'm expecting another phone call here any minute from my agent so that we can work out some of the finer details on the matter. Looking forward to it like quite a bit. What if we planted a forest around places That would be a good thing, because then I'd be abiding by my saying. I've got to do it because if they find out that I haven't abided by my own saying, like, the press is going to call me a hypocrite, and then they're probably going to pull my lines from stores, and we can't have that. All right, up to 5 Ender Pearls. So let's do that definitely. Just set up some nice forestry around here. I could even do it in, like, dedicated planters, but I might just plant it normally. Let's do that. Boom. Yeah, trees. Woo! Looks so sweet. I'm such a nature-y individual. Boom. My house is so nature-y, and then I'm going to chop it down again. I didn't mean to do that. I meant to plant the sapling, but, you know, it's okay. Look at this. Look at this. I can even plant trees on, like, either side of my entryway, but I don't know if I'll go that far. That's a bit too close to nature for my taste. I think we should at least maintain a few blocks separation from nature. Otherwise, things may just get a little too much oxygen for my comfort levels. But hey, that's fine. Some people, they like their oxygen. Me, I'm all about the... I don't know what else I'd be about, but yeah. Because I'd probably die without oxygen. Definitely didn't get up to level 30, so that isn't good. Maybe we want to put the diamond on and just look fully geared out and stuff. Look at this. Look at me. Look at me. Pay attention to me. Look at me when I'm speaking. I have diamond armor. I'm not afraid to use it. Don't actually know what it would mean to... I'm not afraid to use my armor. Yeah. I'm not afraid to deflect potentially lethal hits from people. Not afraid to do that. I'm pretty brave doing that or something. I don't know. All I know is I'm running out of inventory space there. That stuff is good. Okay, we're pretty darn good. I would love it. There should be a daybed or something. Daybeds would be great. That's a real piece of furniture. And if we had it in Minecraft, it would make it a lot easier to harvest the brains of an Enderman. Do I have any more carrots? I could have sworn I had some more carrots. There we go. I just want to keep breeding the pigs so that we can continue to get some levels, because maybe it's about time that they're wanting to be bred again. Wanting to be bred, well, not really with bread, but with carrots. So, all right, guys. And then one of these days, I was thinking it might be worth sort of exploring, setting off on foot, trekking through the wilderness, and seeing what sort of stuff can be found in the wild, wild east, west, north, south, wherever we are located. Technically, it's all arbitrary. I don't actually know why are we called the West? In, I guess it's by the dateline that you call something the West and you call something the, and by we I meant like United States is called the West of the Earth, which is a sphere. So I guess it's just we're West if you consider the dateline like the dividing line or something. I don't know. I'm sure there's a very good Wikipedia article explaining that I should probably just read before I sound silly. But logically, you know, when you think about it, it's very hard to define a relative direction on a sphere that's floating through space. And space does not have any sort of... Basically, it's all relative. Everything is relative to everything else. Speed is relative and stuff. And, yeah, okay. Cool, because right now, we're branching off on tangents. I was about to explain speed and why it's all relative. And then I was like, you know what? Let's not do that. It's about summertime. And you're like, I'm just out of year of school, and I don't want that. Thanks. Okay, level 30 again. So, are we going to do it? Are we going to do what we do, which is we do the thing where we put the thing in the enchantment table, and then we see what happens. The question is, do we want fire protection because we've already been to the Nether, or do we want blast protection? That is the question, ladies and gentlemen. It's a big, big question. I feel like, oh, I forgot I had that extra diamond in there. So, okay, anyway. I feel like fire protection is a good thing to have. I do. especially if you ever like fall into lava. It's just, it's good. It's good in case of emergency in hardcore. So fire protection, 4 thorns, 2. Unbreaking would have been great. But hey, I'm not going to complain. Not going to complain at all. Thorns is better for like PvP. It doesn't really help you when it comes to mobs because it just wears down the armor quicker. Because I don't really care about reflecting damage into a mob personally. But hey, whatever floats your goat, you know? Whatever floats your goat. Oh, that's what I was going to do, is I was going to friggin' pig on a stick. Pig on a stick. That's what I was going to do exactly. Let's make a pig on a stick. I meant I was going to make a carrot on a stick for a pig. So that the pig could be just highly, highly happy about, you know. Here we go. Carrot on a stick. Are you ready to ride a pig? Because I'm ready to ride a pig. We're going to ride a pig, and the pig is going to like it. And it's going to be like, wow, Jordan Gert, amazing. Thanks so much for giving me this opportunity to provide transportation to you. He's going to say it in plain English like that, because as soon as you put a saddle on a pig and dangle a carrot in front of it, it all of a sudden grows this massive, massive brain. Pigs are actually really smart, though. They are. Pigs can learn to do tricks and stuff, and I remember a long time ago, there was this show on, like, was it Animal Planet, I think? That, go, pig, go, go. What do we want to call him? What do we want to call this majestic beast that we've just boarded who's freaking majestic? But really, anyway, there was a pet talent show thing that was on like Animal Planet a long time ago. I don't know if it still exists, but they a lot of people brought their pigs on because pigs are really smart and they could do really cool things like pick up a basketball and or a small basketball and like dunk it in a small hoop. Things like that. Really smart. So this dude, friggin' smart. He knows what he wants. Carrots. He'll do anything for it. Okay, but really, you need to go quicker. All right, you need to go quicker. Can you go? Go! Go, you can do this. I wish you could jump. Whee! We're on our way. Yeah, go! Ride like the wind! Ride like the wind, whatever your name is. I don't know what your name is, but you're, Oinkles McCarrotingtons. Oinkles McCarrotins? Keratin's another thing entirely. You're really slow now. I wish you weren't as slow. I know I can right-click, but oh, I thought you'd be a lot faster. You now have a following. Look at this. Look at this, man. Did you ever once expect that this would be your life? A life where you can navigate through the world and you'd have followers? Look at this following that we are about to gather for you. Oh my god. How amazing is this? Oinkles McCarrotins. I bet you never thought that you'd be a freaking celebrity. And that everyone in the entire pig world would love you and follow you and cherish you and protect you at all costs in the event of a terrible tragedy that might possibly befall you. Look at this, we're gonna keep gathering followers. Hey, followers, Oinkles McCarrotin is here and you better show some respect, okay? This is a serious, serious motorcade, all right? Basically like the president of the Pig-nited States going in here, all right? This is nothing to scoff at. Okay, here we go. Winkles McCarrotin's coming through. He's got his bodyguard riding him, his trusty bodyguard. There we go. Oh my goodness, this motorcade is just unbelievable right now. Holy crap. I've never seen anything like this in my life. Okay, Winkles McCarrotin's, get up here. How are we going to do this, actually? This, like, I have a lot of pigs here. This would be a great addition to make. But, oh boy, here we go. All right, here we go. I don't even know if I can do this. I don't even know if I can do this. Wait, oh, I can do it from this side? There we go. Come on in, come on in. No, 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 no. This might have been just the worst decision I've ever made in my entire life, was to open the gates there. It's actually one of the worst decisions I've ever made. Oinkles McCarrotins, get on in. Everyone will follow you, I promise. That was a really, really bad decision. That was really bad. It's actually so dense that I can't do it. Nope, I can't do it. I've made a terrible mistake. Oinkles McCarrotins got me. He was campaigning so hard and I was like, wow, that's amazing, Oinkles McCarrotins. Okay, everybody single file. You can get in here. Oinkles McCarrotins made it in. That means the rest of them are gonna make it. Aren't they? Get in, close the gate! allow me to close. Is the gate closed, actually? Is it? I think it's closed. No, it's not. It's not closed. It's not at all closed. It's still not closed. Alright. No, it's not.
What have I done?
I've made a terrible, terrible mistake. Please, everybody. In an orderly fashion. You know what? It was time to thin out the herd anyway. It's time to thin out the herd, so. No, guys! Don't. Okay. We have a lot to kill now. We have a lot to kill. It's fine. Oh, fire aspect. Hold on. Hold on. Oh, you're a baby. You're a baby. I'm so sorry. I killed a baby piggy. A baby piggy. I needed some food anyway. I was running a little bit low. I wasn't really running low at all, but whatever. I should have just killed all the Oinkles McPiggington's followers. He was planning he was staging a coup. He was like, Jordan, you have accumulated too much power in the world, and now you must die. And I was like, nah, I'm not going to have that. Not going to have that. We're in hardcore. I'd never come back. Oinkles McPiggington's. Oh, I see. The error of your way. Do you see? I'm making an example of all of your followers. Yes. You now see the error, the grave mistake you have made, and I will let you live to watch. I'll let you live alone once again. All right, Enderman, it's time. It's time that you give me an Ender Pearl. Can you do that, please? Because that would be just the best. That'd be just the bee's knees, because you don't have any knees, so I couldn't be like it's Enderman's knees because you don't have knees, so. All right. All right, man. Come on, Enderman. I see another one over here. We just need some Enderman. That's really all that we need. Okay, come here. Come here, you. I know you're just sitting there all peaceful amongst the flowers and stuff, but I really just need you to have... Unbelievable that the lack of Ender Pearls in this world... Oh my gosh. Well, you know what? I think I may wind things down here for this episode. Lots of really stingy Endermen out here. It's a shame. It's a darn shame. We can't get more donors. But I guess we gotta live with what we got. Gotta deal with the hands we're dealt. So anyway, on that note, thank you very much for watching this episode of Hardcore Survival. Hope you've enjoyed. And if you have a rating, it would be super duper very much appreciated. And yeah, I guess I'll see you next time.